year, and it's all in the city of Cincinnati. Because there is no cooperation agreement, all of the money that they had to purchase was spent in the city of Cincinnati. Now, they made an effort to do the purchases in neighborhoods that are already concentrated, but Cincinnati has a very, very large percentage of public housing compared to the rest of the county. And the purchases this year add to that concentration of the city of Cincinnati because they could not have a cooperation agreement by the county. They have other monies that must be spent in this way. Basically, the monies come from the fact that when they closed down the beach woods, that HUD said they had to replace units. Okay, they had to buy or purchase public housing in their jurisdictions. So they have more money in 2012, and if a cooperation agreement is not signed, that money will also not be spent in the city of Cincinnati. So that's one immediate consequence. The other consequence is that the people who filed the lawsuit that was settled back in 1988 and signed on to a consent decree from that lawsuit that required the county to sign a cooperation agreement are ready to file in federal court for the county to enforce that old consent decree and say the refusal of the county to sign, you know, is a violation of that consent decree and ask the judge to hold them to. They don't necessarily want to do that, but they are prepared to do that. That complaint is drafted and it will probably be filed shortly. That would mean that we as taxpayers in Hamilton County will have to foot the legal bills to fight that once again, to fight an issue that was supposedly settled decades ago. But perhaps the biggest consequence is that Hamilton County receives millions of dollars in federal funds through HUD, through community development block grants and other block grants that support housing, support community development efforts. Those monies come with a requirement that the county further fair housing, not just not actively discriminate, but further fair housing. If HUD fines the county by refusing to sign a cooperation agreement, is violating their agreement to further fair housing, all that money will be pulled. And folks in the county said, well, they won't do that. Well, that may have been true 5 years ago, but HUD is very serious about this requirement now. They have pulled federal dollars in several jurisdictions in the last 7 years for failing to further fair housing. Westchester County, New York, had their block grant dollars withheld because they have not further fair housing. Recently, Joliet, Illinois, had the monies withheld because they had not done it. HUD, my perception, Jim can talk some more about HUD's position on it. My perception is that there are folks at HUD that are very, very serious about this and are prepared to withhold the millions of dollars in money coming to Hamilton County if the county does not sign a cooperation. Something as simple as saying we will cooperate with the housing authority and, you know, and allow scattered site housing at various places throughout the county and the suburbs as well as in the university. That is, you know, to me, that is over the top dangerous for the county in a time of budget crisis to be putting at risk those millions of dollars for something that is absolutely not necessary. And basically takes us back into the 50s and 60s as far as where we are with immigration issues. You know, it's clear to me, and I've given you, you know, of course, my perspective on it, but it's clear to me, I mean, most people agree that the property owned by the housing authority is some of the best maintained rental property in the city. You know, they do a good property management job. The tenants that call us all the time make it really clear that they are very serious and tough landlords as far as tenant behavior goes, probably tougher than most of the private landlords in the city are. It's really clear that, you know, disagreements about public housing don't have to do with the property, don't have to do with the landlord, it has to do with the residents. It has to do with people trying to keep others out of their communities. And to me, it's just really sad that we are back in the days of having to decide whether African Americans should be allowed to move into a white neighborhood. And I think that's what this issue basically is about. With that perspective, I'm gonna, just to make clear, and I think people know this, Kelly is with CMHA, Cincinnati Metropolitan Housing Authority, an independent government body set up under the laws of the state of Ohio. Most counties have a housing authority. They manage the properties, the affordable housing, the public housing. Jim is with HUD, a federal agency. HUD doesn't own any properties, okay? Except maybe the ones they foreclosed on. But basically, HUD is the funder. HUD funds the housing authority. So when the monies come from the federal government, it comes through HUD, and HUD sets the rules and regulations on how it works. So those are perhaps the different rules. Kelly represents the housing authority. Jim represents HUD, who gives the housing authority the money and calls the shots and the rules. So let's hear it a little bit. We'll stay up here and have them give you a little more in depth from their perspective, and then I'd really like a discussion on it.